morning students, my name is Khushbu and we are back with our next video. Hope you all are fit and fine and taking all the precautions related to coronavirus. So our next topic is chapter number 4, Friends of Class 5, book term 1. The poem written by Abby Fowell Brown. She was an American author and poet. In 1900, she published her first children's book, The Book of Saints and Friendly Beasts. In the poem, Friends, Brown shares that even things in nature can be children's friends, giving them comfort whenever they fail. Now let's recite the poem together. How good to lie a little while and look up through the tree. The sky is like a kind big smile, bend sweetly over me. The sunshine flickers through the lace of leaves above my head and kisses me upon the face like mother before bed. The wind comes chilling over the grass to whisper pretty things, and though I cannot see him pass, I feel his careful wings. So many gentle friends are near, whom one can scarcely see. A child should never feel a fear, wherever he may be. By Abby Fowell Brown. In the poem, Abby Fowell Brown explains the many different aspects of nature, such as the cool of the wind and the soft touch of the sun. Each stanza describes a specific element of nature. In the first stanza, the speaker begins by making a statement about the pleasure available when one takes the time to step into nature. She brings up the way it feels good to lie and look up through the tree. In the next two lines, a technique called personification is used. Basically, in this, the poet has given human-like qualities to the forces of nature. That is, the sky, the sun, and the wind. Like the sky is like a kind big smile, and it bent over as she looked up at it. In second stanza, the speaker goes on to describe the sky in more detail. It's not just blue. There is also the sunshine. It appears off and on through the lace of leaves. She used the word lace as the effect of sunlight through the leaves of trees onto her face, and the ground around her makes lace pattern over there. In next two lines, she refers the feelings of pleasure and safety one gets when they are given kisses on their face by their mother. You might also feel same for your mother. Hear joy and love conveyed through a kiss. In stanza 3, poet talks about another force at work in and around the sky above her head. That is the wind. The wind is described as chilling over the grass around the speaker. It seems to sneak up on her, as if wanting to surprise her with its whisper. She imagined wind is speaking to her, telling her pretty things. The wind is further personified in the next two lines. She describes it as passing on careful wings. She knew that the wind was there, but could not see him pass. In the last stanza, the speaker goes on to describe the wind, sky and sunshine as being gentle friends. The fact that the sky, sun and wind are forever present in one's world means that a child should never feel a fear. These friends represent the power of God. Thank you for watching the video. Hope you understood the poem. Like and subscribe the video and don't forget to mention your name, class and section. Have a nice day.